Hello friends, welcome to the channel Solution. Today in this video we will show you how to perform the limit test of sulphate in given sample. Before starting the experiment, let's know what is limit test.
Limit test is used to determine the inorganic impurities present in any chemical compound. Here, the limit means value or amount that is likely to be present in a substance. Test means to examine or to investigate, and impurities means a foreign matter which is present in compound. So, limit test is defined as the quantitative or semi-quantitative test designed to identify and control the small quantities of impurities which is likely to be present in the substance. And this limit test is generally carried out to determine the inorganic impurities present in the compound. In short, limit test is nothing but to identify the impurities present in the substance and compare it with the standard. Means to find out that the amount of the impurities present in the substance is within the limit or beyond the limit. Means to find out the amount of impurities present in the substance is avoidable or unavoidable. In the limit test, turbidity or color or a stain or opalescence produced by the reaction of the impurities which is present in the test sample with the reagent we used is compared with the standard turbidity, color, stain or opalescence produced by the reaction of known amount of impurities, means standard, with the same reagent we used in the test.
Next, what is the principle of limit test of sulphate? The principle of this test is that the barium sulphate reagent which we use in this test contain barium chloride. And this barium chloride which is present in this reagent, when react with the soluble sulphate present in the standard solution and also present as impurity in the sample solution, when this barium chloride react with the sulphate in the presence of dilute HCl form barium sulphate. And this barium sulphate is solid insoluble particle, and due to this barium sulphate the solution become turbid, means the turbidity of the solution is due to this barium sulphate. And if in our test solution the turbidity which occur after the reaction is greater than the turbidity of the standard solution, it means the impurities of the sulphate which is present in our solution in our sample is more than that of the standard limit. It means our sample not pass the limit test of sulphate. And if the turbidity of the test solution is less than the turbidity of the standard solution, it means the impurity of sulphate is within the limit, means the test sample passed the limit test of sulphate. Let's start the experiment. For the limit test of sulphate, we require potassium sulphate solution of concentration 0.1089% weight by volume, prepare in distilled water. Here we have prepared 20 ml of potassium sulphate solution. Next we require distilled water. Then next to distilled water, here we require barium sulphate reagent. Barium sulphate reagent is prepared by adding 15 ml of 15 ml of barium chloride solution of concentration 0.05 molar. And to this 15 ml of 0.05 molar barium chloride solution, add 55 ml of distilled water. And then add 20 ml of ethanol and 5 ml of potassium sulphate solution of concentration 0.01818%, and dilute it with the distilled water up to 100 ml mark. And this is how the barium sulphate reagent is prepared. Next we require dilute HCl. First we have to prepare the standard solution. For this, take clean and dry Nessler cylinder, and to this Nessler cylinder transfer 1 ml of potassium sulphate solution of known concentration, means standard potassium sulphate solution of concentration 0.1089% weight by volume, means here we have dissolved 10.89 gram of potassium sulphate in 100 ml of distilled water. Here we have prepared 20 ml of potassium sulphate solution. For this, 2.178 gram of potassium sulphate dissolved in 20 ml of distilled water. After this, to this Nessler cylinder add 2 ml of dilute HCl, and then dilute this solution up to 45 ml mark in the Nessler cylinder with distilled water. After diluting the solution up to 45 ml with distilled water, then next we have to add 5 ml of barium sulphate reagent. After transferring 5 ml of barium sulphate reagent, after transferring this to the Nessler cylinder, then mix it properly with the help of glass drawer. Then keep this standard solution aside for 5 minutes. Now, next for the test solution. For this we require another clean and dry Nessler cylinder. Then transfer 1 ml of the sample solution to this Nessler cylinder. After this, we have to follow the same procedure as we have done for the standard. Means again we have to add 2 ml of dilute HCl to this Nessler cylinder containing sample, and then dilute this solution up to 45 ml with distilled water in the Nessler cylinder. Then we have to add 5 ml of barium sulfate reagent. And after adding 5 ml of barium sulfate reagent, then mix the content of the Nessler cylinder with the help of glass rod. After mixing properly with the help of glass rod, then keep this Nessler cylinder aside for 5 minutes. Now observe both the Nessler cylinder in black background. Here you can see that right side is the standard solution and the left side is the test solution. And both the solution is turbid, means turbidity occur in both the solution. Now the turbidity of the standard solution is compared with the test solution. And if the turbidity of the test solution is less than the standard solution, it means our sample passed the limit test. And if the turbidity of the test solution is greater than the turbidity of the standard solution, it means our sample not passed the limit test. Means the test solution turbidity must be less than the standard solution. Now here you can see that the test solution turbidity is less than the standard solution. It means our sample passed the limit test of sulfate. And this is how we perform the limit test of sulfate in any sample. And this video is also available in Hindi explanation. Link is given in the description box. Thank you very much for watching this video.